Book of Ezekiel, chapter 9. The prophet says, in the city, there was all kinds of abomination. And in that situation, the prophet saw a vision. So many people were carrying the swords. The swords symbolizes people are entering into violence when things go wrong. When things go wrong, the first thing people take is sword. They want to fight. Amidst this, the Lord showed to Ezekiel a man who was wearing a linen cloth, and he had some ink on his hands. And the heaven is asking, somebody is asking, who is this man? Everybody is carrying the sword, and this fellow is different. He is carrying something, an ink and bottle and something to mark. And the word was said, do you know why this man is carrying? God is looking for people who can see the abomination in the world and who can cry to heaven that God may not punish this world, rather God may transform these people. In other words, God is looking for people, the intercessors, who can transform the wrath into mercy, that God may not punish, people may not enter into destructive themselves, but rather they will come to their senses with the mercy and knowledge of God, and they may move from anger to love, to life, to salvation. So God is looking for such people, and God will put a mark on such type of people, and such kind of people are the need of the hour. This is the same thing repeated by Ezekiel in chapter 18. Where he said, God is looking for people who can stand in between God and man to save the mankind. Yes. So the Lord says, have the burden for the Lord. This is the first thing God is asking from today's first reading. When you see the world is dying, world is being destroyed, you can get angry, you can get upset, you can take your sword, you can abuse. That is a group of people are doing in the world. But as a child of God, you should have the burden for the world, the dying world. And if you have the burden for the salvation of the world, second thing the Bible says is, the heaven will recognize you. The heaven will recognize who are the people who are feeling sigh. Oh, my people are dying. Oh, my people are going the wrong way. Oh, my people have to be saved. If you have the burden, because that is the heart of God. If you have the heart of God, when you see the people who are dying, the heaven will recognize it. Third, the heaven will send his angels to put a mark on you that you are someone belonging to God. We read in the book of Genesis chapter 3 when Cain cried to God that everybody may catch me and they may kill me. God put a mark on Cain and said, this man belongs to God. If anybody touches this man, God will take control of it. So God puts mark on those who feel for the people, who carry the burden of the Lord to bring salvation to the sinful world. And they will be known as God's people. And the fourth we read in from today's first reading is, when everybody get destroyed, those who have the mark will be protected. They will be specially protected. That's what we read in the book of Exodus. When all the Egyptians were killed, the people of Israel who had the blood mark on their doors, they were protected. My dear friends, today the Lord is telling, number one, have the burden for the dying world. Have the heart of God. Have the eyes of God. Have the cry of God. When Jesus saw Jerusalem going to die destroyed, he cried. Today God is looking for people. If you have the burden for the Lord and for the world, the second, the heaven will recognize you. Third, God will put a mark on you and tell the whole world that you are his. Fourth, such people will be protected from all the evil ones. In the gospel of today, Jesus says about a man who is not agreeing with you. When people don't agree with you, when people don't bother you, that is the gospel of Matthew chapter 18, which says, when people are not agreeing with you, the first thing that will happen is, number one, Satan will come. When somebody is not agreeing you, he will come in the form of anger and irritation. 2 Corinthians chapter 4 verse 4 says, when people are not agreeing with you, he is working on your mind. He will bring anger and irritation. We read in Proverbs chapter 19 verse 11, good sense makes one to slow to anger, and it is his glory to overlook offense. But the enemy, if you are not alert, when somebody is not agreeing with you, the first thing he will make you getting irritated and get angry. The second thing he will do is bring bitterness to hit back the fellow who is not agreeing and to prove that you are right and he is wrong. We read in the gospel, in the Bible tells us in Hebrews chapter 12 verse 15, see to it that no one falls short of the grace of God, and see to it that no bitter root grows up to cause trouble and defile you. If you allow bitterness, it will become rooted in you and it will defile you before defiling others, and it will destroy everybody. So the first thing we find is, Jesus says, when people don't agree with you, number one, anger and irritation, Satan will make it. Second, he will bring bitterness. Third, he will tell you, this guy is useless. Avoid him. Matthew chapter 5, verse 22. Don't call anyone fool. If you call anyone fool who are created by God in his image, you have to answer God. Or the fourth thing Satan will do is, he will make oneself, oh, these fellows are not agreeing with me, they are not bothering me, so he will make you a sad and depressed person. Proverbs chapter 17 verse 22 says, the bitterness will dry up all your bones. So it is natural in the world, people may not accept, and when people don't accept, lose them or destroy them, and by destroying them, destroy yourself. This is the response of the enemy. If you are not alert, the enemy can make you to get anger and irritated. The enemy can make you to be bitter and hit back and prove you are right and the other is wrong, or to avoid that fellow as useless waste candidate, or fourth, you yourself become victim and become bitter and you become depressed. On the other hand, God says in Romans chapter 8 verse 5 to 6, we read, if you allow your mind to be given to the Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit will lead you to life. If you don't give your thoughts when others don't accept you, the evil spirit can lead you to flesh and to death. So when things go wrong, when people don't accept you, you have to be in touch with your thoughts. How does your thought look into that situation and deals with it is very, very important. That's why Mark chapter 7 verse 20, Jesus said, what comes out of a person will defile the person. So be careful of what is happening to your mind when people are not agreeing with you. And be alert when people don't agree with you, what comes from your mouth. These two you have to take care. So what does God say? God says, the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 10 verse 5, when people don't agree with you, do not allow any thought to pass over you. Capture every thought and bring it to the light of Christ and transform the thought as God wants you to deal with. What is the meaning of that? When people don't accept you, number one, you have to bring to your mind the vision of God for man. When people don't accept you or accept your argument or whatever may be, number one, you bring to your mind the vision of God for man. Because your visions should be as that of the Lord, then you will live. What is the vision of God for man? It is given in John 3:16. God so loved the world that he sent his only son, that not a single one should perish, but rather everyone should live. So even when people disagree with you, they don't accept you, see to it that because of you, somebody is not destroyed, but somebody has life. Join with the vision of God. Second, the Lord says, as you think, everyone have the freedom to think. You got to bring it to your mind, what is the vision of God for man? Number two, you should think, as you have the freedom to think and talk, the another also has the right to think and talk. In the book of Philippians chapter 2 verse 3 says, consider others better than yourselves. Third, the Bible says, Jesus says, instead of Satan's program of getting angry or irritated or bitter or avoiding the fellow as useless, try to earn the fellow. Try to win over the guy. Try to bring him to the kingdom. How? He says, move into conversation. If he is not accepting you, okay, call one or two persons, his friends or your friends, who can convince him. But don't afford to lose any fellow, because the vision of God is not a single one should perish, but everyone should have everlasting life. And you and I, we have very short time in this world. And we have no achievement than the achievements of God. Our call is to join with God and to bring God's kingdom on this earth. Yes. So move in conversation. By all means, you try your best to win over the guy. That is the goal of a Christian. If even for the two fellows he is not agreeing, call the church, the elders, and try to converse with him. That fellow will begin to think, oh, I'm so important. This fellow is not even leaving me. Yes, he himself will come down when somebody is angry on you. The moment you say sorry from your part, even though you are not done anything, when you lower down your voice, automatically things will come. The Bible says, if you see little fire, if you spit it out, it will go away. Instead, if you blow it out, it will become a big thing and destroy everything. So don't lose people. It is easy to lose people. Now you are called to win over people and build up God's kingdom. God has trusted you. So if you are listened, look for, that's why Bible says, move into conversation and save the people. 2 Corinthians chapter 5 verse 18 says, while we are still sinners, Jesus came and died on the cross and reconciled us with the Father. That we too, in our lives, there are so many people who make mistakes, and we reconcile with them and we lead them to heaven. Yes. So if you are listened by this method Jesus is teaching you, that if he is not listening to you, take your friends, and even if he doesn't listen, take to the church. Don't leave the guy. If you listen and not losing the guy, and if you could join with him, the Bible says, when two or three are joined together and pray, the heaven himself will be opened for you, and the heaven himself will make you blessing, and even the another guy whom you thought to be a problem, he will become a blessing. Your life is for a mission, and that mission is, God so loved the world that he is sending his only son for you and me, that no one should perish, but everyone should have life everlasting. Amen.